Mem is one of the most interesting productivity apps and note-taking applications on the market, and they just got out of beta, introducing Mem X and Teams. In today's video, I'm going to break down the different pricing structures that Mem has recently launched as they are no longer in beta, and the different features that you can find on Mem X. For those of you that are not familiar with Mem, it is a really nice note-taking application that has been in beta for the past year. And many people have showcased it in videos like myself and showed how it has a lot of nice integration functionality, a lot of nice different note-taking functionality in general. I have a review of the entire application that you can go watch over here, but essentially it has an interesting take on how you can do note-taking. So where does this new Mem X pricing leave us? Prior to this, obviously it was all free, but for free, you still are getting a unlimited amount of Mems, tags, and templates, and 25 megabytes file size per upload, as well as 5 gigabytes total of storage. But when you go into Mem X, it gets to a little bit more of a premium price here. This is actually similar to what something like Evernote costs. So this $10 a month is significantly higher than Notion, which is more like $4 a month. And then for Mem X Teams, $15 a month, and Mem X Enterprise is going to be even higher than that. But the thing to remember about Mem is this. With Mem X, you're actually going to get self-organizing Mem X technology. And what does that mean? With similar Mems, you'll see Mems that are relevant to the Mem you're working on appear in real time in your related Mem sidebar. No tagging needed. So the AI essentially figures out what you're typing and showcases to you similar ones that you have done before. So a Mem is essentially a note. And this application is claiming that it is going to have AI that is good enough to essentially take what you're talking about and have the AI recognize it so that you can do quick links and references to those other notes that you made. And then with smart search, you can move beyond keyword and tag search, searching for content that isn't ever mentioned directly in a Mem and still find what you're looking for. A search for a meeting with payment company will find Stripe call January 17th, 2022. So for those of you that don't know, Stripe is a payment service similar to like PayPal where people can utilize it so that they can receive payment for services that they've done. And this just keeps showing you, if you see on the bottom here, a bunch of different examples of smart search. And this is something where we can find really good understanding of what our notes are through the way our brain thinks. Most people, when they're looking for something, they don't really think about it in the way that we title different things. Obviously, it's really nice to title something as, you know, call with OpenSea or whatever, but we think about what was the name of that NFT company that I just did a meeting with. So we look up NFT company and then it'll smart search for that. Or what was year over year growth in March? And then it shows you the quarter one metrics or different notes from team meetings. And the great part about this technology is the fact that in a team setting, Mem is claiming essentially if you have these different smart features, you don't really need to worry about tagging and whatnot, because if you're gonna search for something, the aggregated files from all your different team members are going to be smart searchable. And you will not need to tag them properly. Because if I am somebody who's using just Mem as it is now, we can see that I have a bunch of different tags here. Like I have a daily Mem tag, a journal tag, a recipe tag, and tutorial tag. Now, if I want to look for something like this, I would have to go in here and do a #journal to sort of get all the tagged stuff for things that were journaled. But if I were to just do a search for something else, I would get a smart Mem search done if I had Mem X. The power of AI in note-taking is finally coming to the forefront of productivity apps, and this is the first example of what I've mentioned to people who know my opinion on this. There is going to be all-in-one workspaces that are possible because applications like this are great now, but once processing power continues to improve and companies develop their tech stack, I think all of these applications are going to eventually become all-in-one workspaces that are powerhouses with AI. I'm excited for that, but I'm also excited for you guys to check out this video on how to improve your productivity even more.